episode 849, The Abundance Mindset.
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by.
Happy, happy day. I hope you have recovered from your weekend and you are well rested and rejuvenated for a brand new week. Get up, move around, jump around, get that blood pumping because God has got a full day plan for you. It's Mindset Monday, and we are chatting all about the abundance mindset. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, it's all about the abundance mindset. And most people stay grounded in what they know. We've been talking about this lately, haven't we? It feels like we're kind of on a mission here. Well, we are on a mission. So in order to expand your influence, you will need to adopt the abundance mindset. And when we're talking about influence, that might be like your finances, growing your business, reaching and getting to your dreams, accomplishing your goals. That's your influence, your overall impact. Now, if you stay rooted in what you know, how can you go farther? I don't know. How can you? Well, you have to adopt the abundance mindset. You have to change your thoughts to change your life. So what is the abundance mindset? Well, let's break it down. Abundance, that's a great word. It means plentifulness of good things. We all want a plentifulness of good things. It was, when I was growing up, it was fun. We'd go and visit my grandparents, and we moved all the time. You know, I don't know how many times I've moved now. We're over 25 times, I think, maybe 26. I don't know, I've lost count. Maybe we're headed up to 27, but it's been a lot. And when we would go as a family to go visit my grandma and my grandpa, we would drive up, and this is where my mom now lives, on our 13 acres there on a family farm. It's now back to a family farm. It wasn't for a little while, and then my mom moved back permanently after my dad completely retired, and they made it now into the family farm. Well, long story short, when we visited there, Grandma would always have this basket on her counter. And in that basket would be usually fresh fruits from their garden or from the trees. They would have apple trees and pear trees, and they would have strawberries and green beans. And so there was always fresh of something. There was a plentifulness of good things. And we would arrive a little bit tired because what is it about driving that is just so exhausting? I don't know. I was never driving. I was just the passenger. But yet, I was so tired. So Grandma always would have something ready for us and then plentifulness of good things for us to enjoy to feed our stomach. That's abundance, prosperity, being prosperous. You want to feel that. You want to have it. Oh my goodness, it's overflowing. God wants to bless you beyond anything you can dream or imagine. But when you let your small-mindedness, it is our fault. I just got to tell you that. It's our fault. And our scarcity mindset. Continue to blossom. Where's your influence? Where's your impact? Where's your growth? There is none. It's stifled. You're frozen. It's like you're frozen in time because that's all you know. That's why most people stay grounded in what they know. It's not just about their comfort zone. Yeah, it is. But it's because, well, this is what we're used to. This is what we know. It's good enough. When it's good enough, that's not the abundance mindset. But you see, you can be prosperous. So don't get down on this. However, you need to make a shift, and that shift needs to come in the abundance mindset. As I mentioned before, God wants to supply you with all his riches. Philippians 4:19 says this, "And my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus." Let's move you out of barely enough and have you become rooted in more than enough. It makes you smile, doesn't it? I can see it now. You're like, I've been waiting for like the last 10 years. I've been trying to run this business for the last 4 years and look where it's gotten me. I am ready. I want more than enough. Well, how do you get a grip on the abundance mindset? Here is your KISS, the Keep It Simple strategy. Change your perceptions to broaden your horizon. That's a lot to digest. Change your perceptions to broaden your horizons. You see, I can look at a situation and an experience and see it totally different than you looking at the same thing. We would write a totally different story. Your main character may be somebody totally different than the one that I see as the main character. The emotions that you draw from it might be totally different than the emotions I draw from it. It's our perceptions. And our perceptions come from our experiences. So sometimes what happens in our life is that we are limited because we are limited to our experiences. And that's not necessarily a bad thing. It's just a fact. And we need to look at it as such. Don't get overly emotional as to the attachment of, oh, but let me tell you my sob story or let me tell you my awesome story. Either way, it doesn't matter. Okay? Your perception comes from your experiences, and your experiences are done with how your life has been shaped by decisions that have been made and placed upon you or decisions that you have made personally. When you were a little child, you couldn't make some of those decisions. I couldn't make decisions whether or not I was moving all the time. I didn't have a say. Now, every once in a while, as we got older, they would ask and say, if we move here, how do you feel about that? Okay, we would have discussions, but ultimately it was mom and dad's choice. So change your perceptions to broaden your horizon. The abundance mindset. So let's break it down a little bit. Number one, it must start with gratitude. No, don't shrug your shoulders at me. Gratitude for where you came from. We're talking about your past. It is what it is. You can't change it. I don't care if you grew up in poverty. I am sorry that that happened. I am sorry even if you grew up with more than enough. Either way, see, we're talking about perceptions, right? It's the past. You can't change it. Because some people would say, but I would love to have more than enough growing up. I mean, we barely were able to put bread and water on the table. I mean, we ate literally beans. We were lucky to have rice. And we would get bread only because it was leftover and it was like two-day-old bread. That is your past. You cannot change your past. But you see, you have probably a higher gratitude. You're more accepting of having a little bit more. You're more grateful because you didn't have it growing up. Where someone who was had all they wanted and more, maybe it's kind of like now I'm entitled to. It's perceptions, do you see? So it's really important that you understand this through the entire process. Change your perceptions to broaden your horizon. So it starts with gratitude for where you came from. It is what it is. Be grateful, because you know what? If it didn't work out right, you wouldn't be here today listening to me. I pray you'd be in heaven, but you're not. So that means be grateful. That doesn't mean you had to approve and you're saying, yes, my past was awesome, because most of us, we got something in our past that we really don't want to talk about. That's for another episode. But right now, we're going to look at it with gratitude. Number two, understanding your present situation. A lot of people are hurting because they're living paycheck to paycheck. And they're hurting because with money, money hits it at every corner, at every emotion. It hits us at a relationship level. It can destroy marriages. Finances is the number one thing for divorce. So understanding your present situation is important. Living paycheck to paycheck, view it as a stepping stone to what's to come. God has bigger plans and greater riches for you. Stop living and looking at it as, this is just enough. This is all I'm ever going to have. If that's what you're saying, which I know I've said it, I have said it. Okay? I'm going to be honest with you. And I think if we were all honest, we would have said that already. Maybe you were in this terrible job. Maybe you're still in this terrible job and you're like, gosh darn it, why can't I get further from where I am? I try, I work, I do what I'm supposed to do. I go and I do extra training, I stay over, and it's just not enough. Am I not good enough? I guess this is all I'm ever going to have. If that's your mindset right now, you are living in scarcity. And that's a dangerous place to be. You have to come into the abundance mindset. Change your perceptions to broaden your horizon. So where you are in your situation now, it's a stepping stone to what's to come. There's something bigger on the other side. But sometimes, yes, I'm going to tell you, we have to endure. There's going to be storms. God never said you're going to have a perfect life. He never said that. You go read the Bible. He's never said that. So understand where you're at and know that this is temporary. It's temporary. And also in that same fashion, I want you to understand and accept that, okay, this is where I'm at. You have gratitude for your present situation also. When I go and write my bills, I mean, who really likes to pay bills? I mean, seriously, I don't. But you know what? Every single time I sit down to write bills and pay bills, whether it's online, whether it's snail mail, because yes, I still believe in snail mail, I write them out. And all I can say to God is, I really want to pay off this debt. I wish it was gone, Lord. However, I am grateful that I can still pay whatever the amount is. And I ask for his blessing on it. And out the door it goes. Snail mail, online, whatever. You see, it's a different way of looking at your situation. Instead of saying, oh my gosh, I only could put $35 to this bill. And I really need to be putting more like $155 to it. I'm drowning in debt. I'm never going to get out of it. Scarcity mindset. It's holding you back. Change your perceptions to broaden your horizon. The abundance mindset. And number three, change your thoughts that define your perceptions. Whoa. Yeah, it's your thoughts, because your thoughts feed into everything else. Your thoughts help feed into what? Your emotions. Your thoughts are a foundation to your life and how you live it and how it's followed up with actions. So this is when you say, there's more than enough out there. There is more than enough. I can go out there and be whatever it is you want to be. You have this dream? Yes, you can do that. I have a dream. Am I living the dream yet? I'm in process of living that dream. Have I reached the pinnacle? Nope, I have not. Not in my eyes. And I'm almost pretty sure, because God and I have had conversation, that I haven't reached his pinnacle yet either. But you see, that doesn't mean that I take away from what I'm doing right now. Change your thoughts that define your perceptions. I am going further. There's more than enough out there. I will succeed. God's on my side. When you begin speaking words of plentifulness and prosperity, your actions will then follow. It starts with your thoughts, your foundation. Why do you think I said at the very beginning you got to have that gratitude? Because if you're not grateful from where you came from and you don't show that, that is going to hold you back. That is a guarantee. You might as well stop. I'm being really honest with you. You might as well stop what you're doing. I'm not saying that you're accepting of your past, that you agree with everything that happened to you or with you or for you. But it is in the past, so there's got to be that gratitude so you can let it go and move forward. When you begin speaking words of plentifulness and prosperity, your actions will then follow. Maybe you want help with this. Click on the link, Take Aim, to enjoy a complimentary coaching call with me. There will be a little form that pops up. Fill that out, and that will come directly to me, and that will begin our conversation. And we'll set up a time literally for you and I to talk specific to your situation. Maybe it is about the abundance mindset. I'm here for you. Remember, with God, nothing is impossible. Make this week an absolutely incredible week. Don't define your life by your past. Open up your mind. More than enough, the abundance mindset. Live, love, and impact. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, love, and lots of hugs. We'll talk to you real soon. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.